cliche this. So many times now, often more than ever, we're hearing the words breakthrough and deliverance like we never heard it before. And perhaps tonight, not only in the streets, not only folk that we know, but perhaps tonight there is someone who's in this building tonight that is waiting on a breakthrough. Perhaps tonight there's someone who has been waiting on God to deliver you. I want to just say a word to you tonight, because many of us, when we get frustrated, when we get anxious and we start worrying about what's going to happen in the future, many times we're tempted to make some erroneous moves. I wish I had some help here. You know, because we're kind of people that we want the Lord to come when we want him. We want him to do it when we want it done. We think that whenever we pray, that the Lord ought to move when we say we are. He ought to move. But I'm here to tell you tonight that our God doesn't always work that way. Matter of fact, Granny didn't go very far in school, but Granny really had Jesus down where you can understand him, because she said, "Baby, he may not come when you want him to come, but he'll always show up on time." But my brothers and sisters, many of us, if we're honest with ourselves, some of our lives have been in an uproar. Our lives have been in chaos. Our lives have gone upside down because we're busy making our moves too soon. I wish I had some help here. Because you do understand that the Bible says that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. But the problem with many of us is that we want to get God in a hurry. And sometimes when we try and get him in a hurry, we wind up making a bigger mess out of our life than it ought to be. I wish I had somebody here. And sometimes in haste and desperation, we make our move too soon. But can I tell you tonight, if we and I, you and I, start learning how to wait on God, I wish I had some help here. Because there are some of us who've been on both sides of the spectrum. There are some of us tonight, if we're not minding being honest with ourselves, we made our move too soon, and we look back in hindsight and said, if I had known then what I know now, if I just waited a little while longer, I might not be in the shape that I'm in. But then there's some of us who have learned from experience, knowing that the Lord always does what he said he's going to do. The Lord is no shorter than his promise. And there's some of us who learned how to wait on him, that when we wait on him, God always does what he promised. But tonight, when we look at the life of David, y'all know David, don't you? That many of us look at him and we marvel at who he was. Because many of us, when we think about David, we think about him as a king. We think about him as an anointed king that the Lord had took from virtually nowhere and made him somebody. And so can I tell you tonight that that's the kind of God that we serve, that's the reason why that you and I ought not mind giving God praise, that's the reason why we ought not mind doing what we can for the Lord. Because if the truth is told, all of us in here are products of where God took us from nowhere to somewhere. And I see some of y'all looking at me tonight, you saying, "Well, preacher, you don't know nothing about me. My folk always had money. I wish I had some help here. You know, I went to the best schools. I had best clothes. You know, we lived pretty good." But can I tell you that before you met Christ, you were on the outside looking in. I want to submit to you tonight, it didn't matter how many clothes your mama bought you. It didn't matter how big the house daddy made for you. If you didn't know Christ, you really didn't have anything. And I want to submit to us tonight that if you don't have Christ in your life, you're not living, you're merely existing. Oh, wish I had some help here. But because you do understand that all of those things that you have, you didn't get it on your own. I wish you look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, "You didn't get it on your own, baby. I know you went to college. I know you got degrees. I know you worked really in the heart, but you could have done it if it had not been for the Lord, because there were people that tried to put stumbling blocks in your way. Some of them started when you was a child. You know, they weren't going nowhere. They weren't doing anything. And so they tried to make sure that they told you you weren't going nowhere. Anybody had folk like that? You would never amount to anything. Then when you grew up, you had folk that wasn't going nowhere. You know, they tried to do what they could to stop you. And some of us even done some things to try and stop ourselves.
That's right.
Amen. We can't blame it on everybody, because there's some of us that have had some reckless behavior. I wish, maybe I'm the only one. Maybe I'll just go ahead and testify myself, David. Yeah, but when I was growing up, I did some reckless thing. I did some crazy stuff. Matter of fact, sometimes I'll think it when I think about some of the crazy, erroneous, ignorant stuff that I did in my life, I get scared. But then I don't stay scared for long, because I got to lift my hand and tell God, thank you, because God kept me even when I was doing foolish stuff.
And so
David became a king. They were mystified by his bravery, because even as a shepherd boy, he killed wild animals with his bare hands. David was a warrior, because he defended kingdoms. But David was not crazy to think that he was in it all by himself, because he realized, I got a mighty, that he never would have made it if it had not been for the Lord. And since I'm here tonight, I just want to ask, is there anybody in this building tonight that can testify that I never would have made it where I am right now if it had not been for the Lord? I wish I had somebody here that they don't mind admitting that I wouldn't have made it, because there were times that I felt like giving up. There were times that I felt like throwing in the towel, but I never would have made it if it had not been for the Lord. David knew where he was, because David, even when he got elevated, David still made some mistakes. I want to submit to some of us holy rollers out of here, a super saint, that even though you might be a holy roller and a super saint, there's still some time that you make some mistakes. Maybe I'm the only one here tonight, but listen, since I've been saved, I have done some crazy stuff. Since I've been saved, I have said some stuff that I ought not to say. Since I've been saved, I have been in some places that I should not have been. But anybody here like me, glad that he looked beyond your father? He was out on his terrace, and he saw a beautiful woman bathing out there on the balcony. Now you got to understand that David was not hurting for female companionship. I wish I had some help here. Because David had multiple wives and concubines. But it was something about that woman that was on the balcony that rested his attention. And David, just like some of us, we got everything that we need and then some. But we looking over yonder, y'all in here, looking at what belonged to somebody else. So you know the story. David had to have her. He had her. She became impregnated. And David tried to hide his sin. But David understood that when you sin, you might be able to hide for a minute from folk, but you can never hide from God. Because, and listen, can I tell you something? That's why you ought to be thankful for the man of God, because even when David was trying to hide, God still sent him a word. And I just want to tell you on Sunday morning, don't get us upset with your pastor when God starts speaking. You just ought to just lift your hand and tell God, thank you for giving me what I need instead of taking me out of here. But David in the text, unless I be too long tonight, David openly reveals the benefits of his blessing.
All right.
Because it was the Lord.
Right.
Can I tell you, in these crazy and chaotic times in which we're living, we need a little good news. I wish I had some help here. Because every time you turn on your television set, Pastor Chappelle, all you hear is bad news. Turn it on NBC, bad news. CBS, bad news. Turn it on CNN.
news. But I discovered that many times when you come looking for some good news, there's some folk there with some bad news. And I don't know how y'all feel about it, but I've got too much going on. I catch too much hair on a daily basis to come with some bad news. I need to hear some good news. I want to hear what's on Facebook. I don't want to hear what's on Instagram. I don't care who going with who. I wish I had somebody talk to me tonight. I need to hear a word from. I wish you'd tell your neighbor, I need to hear a word from the Lord. Because he knows the help I know, I need to hear a word from the Lord. But not only did David share the secret to his success, but then he reveals his relationship with the Lord. Can I submit to you tonight that trouble will reveal your relationship with the Lord? I wish I had somebody here. But when you find yourself going through trouble, and for those of you who don't know what trouble is, listen, there are three kinds of folk in this world. There's folk that are going through trouble. There's folk that been in trouble. And for those of you that are sitting here tonight that say you don't know what the other two are, baby, just keep on living. Keep on getting up and going to bed at night. Later you're going to have some trouble, but trouble shows your relationship with God. Because look what he says. He says, teach me thy way. Wish I had some help here. And listen, we discovered that our way really don't work. Anybody here ever tried to do things your way? Anybody here ever tried to solve any problems? Y'all come and talk to me. Your way, and you discovered that your way don't work. So David said, teach me your way. Then he says, lead me in a plain path. Oh, Pastor Whitey, when I looked at this text, Pastor Stewart, when I looked at the text, I had to wonder what it meant by a plain path. And listen, if you had any kind of relationship with God, God will reveal some things to you. Listen, I served 4 years in the United States Marine Corps, and I remember that we had one person in our platoon that was called a guy. Listen, everybody wanted to be a guy because he was the one that was more physically fit. He was the one that got all the attention, and all of us in here wanted it until we discovered what it was really about. Wish I had some help here. Because in wartime, the guy was the one that had to lead you around the booby traps. Oh, I wish I had some help here. That was dangerous. Anybody could not be a guide. And so when I looked at this text, I remembered who our guide really is. Anybody here know who the guide is? It's the Lord. Listen, the only reason why you ain't been wiped out is the Lord been guiding you. Only reason why your enemies ain't been able to get you is because the Lord guides you around. Guides you around. Your enemies. He said, protect me from my enemies. Because many of us really don't know. Somebody already know who our enemies are. Many of our enemies are posing as our friend. Every while, baby, you need to be very, very careful who you tell your business to. Because how many of y'all in here know that an open ear can also be a running mouth? How many of y'all in here know that folk will take your business and they'll run it all over the land and country? You got to be careful of who you talk to. He said, guide me around my enemies. Because what he said is false witness. Have risen up against me. And you know, when God got his hands on you, and let me just throw this one in for free tonight, you don't have to be without flaws for God to have his hand on you. Somebody didn't hear that. Some of y'all just missed your shout cue right there. That you don't have to be perfect. Why? No, because all of us are sitting in here tonight, and the Bible reminds us that all have sinned and come short of, so maybe y'all get it now, that you don't have to be without flaws. I wish you look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, say, I ain't holy every day. Tell him, I serve a holy God, but I ain't holy every day. But I thank even when I have one of my bad days. He says, because false witnesses have risen up against me. And listen, when folk don't like you, they don't have to know nothing about you to talk about you. Listen, most of the folk that don't like you, they don't really know nothing about you. You know, if you ask them what it is they don't like about you, they really can't tell any of you anything concrete. They just don't like you. You ain't said nothing wrong to them. You hadn't mistreated them. You've done the best you can. You speak to them. But if you ask them why they don't like you, they say, I don't know. I just don't like them. But look what David said. David said, I almost got to.
That's right.
Because David said, I almost fainted. And listen, when you get to that point in life, when you've exhausted all of your options, that's really not a bad time. Because I've discovered that a man's extremity is really God's opportunity. Many times when you and I have done everything that we can do, that's when God steps in. Makes a way for you. Listen, when you done call everybody, listen, I want to just tell you tonight that many times that's God's strategic plan. You ever called anybody and tried to get a favor out of them and you weren't able to get them? Anybody here? You know, anybody here ever called somebody and tried to get some help and you couldn't get any help? And then the Lord stepped in. It was a way that you never thought that you could make. I wish I had some help. Anybody here ever tried to borrow any money from somebody? You've been giving them money. You've been loaning them money. And then when you need some, you can't get none. And then you forgot, Reverend Sankey. You went back there looking in your closet and you reached in your pocket. Anybody here? You reached in your purse and there was the money. Anybody here ever did that? There was the money that you were looking for. And you were like, how is it that I didn't find this all along? Well, that was God's strategic plan. He didn't want you to find it then. He wanted you to find it when he wanted you to find it. Because you would know then that it was him and nobody else. In the text, and I'm going tonight. First thing I see is the position to receive the breakthrough. Because look what it says. He says, wait. I'm not making it up. You need to look at it. Wait on the Lord. Now you just can't just sit there and just cross your legs. But you have to wait with expectation. I wish I had some help here. You got to keep on praising him. You got to keep on praying. You got to keep on doing it. And you got to know that if I keep on serving, if I keep on praising, if I keep on doing what the Lord wants me to do, the Lord is going to show up. Not only do I see the position to receive the blessing, but then Pastor Stewart, he talks about his character while he's waiting. Because look what he says. He said, wait on the Lord and be of good courage. Now, what that really means is, while I'm waiting, my character ought not to change. Y'all see that? But while I'm waiting on the Lord to do whatever it is that I need him to do, then I don't need to start acting like a spoiled brat, or y'all in here, or war. When I come in God's house looking like I done lost my very best friend, that I ought to keep the same character when I'm down that I do when I'm up. That's why Paul could say in Philippians 4, he said, whatever state I'm in, I wish I had my Bible readers here tonight. He said, therefore will I be content. Paul said, look, I know how to act, but I got some. I wish I had some help here. I know how to act when I don't have a dime. And listen, ladies and gentlemen, you don't have to act like you're broke even if you are broke. I wish I had some help here. But baby, you got good clothes. You need to put on the good clothes. Baby, you got makeup. I wish I had some help in here. You need to put on the makeup. I wish I had somebody talk to me here. But baby, if you can't go get your hair done, do something to it yourself. Fella, put on your best suit, even if you don't have anything. Going through, they're not gonna help you anyway. All they're gonna do is talk about you. Listen. listen, baby, even if you got to go home and eat pork and beans out of a can, you ought to have prayer. Even if you lost your job, even if you don't have money to pay your bill, you ought to come in and say, this is the day that the Lord has made. Anybody here know you can start the day all broke, but you can leave the day blessed? I wish I had some help here. So many times we talk about the day going from good to bad, but how many know God can take it from bad to good? How many of y'all have ever experienced that? They started out, you didn't know how you were going to make the day. You didn't know how you were going to get through the day. But every hour got a little bit better. Every minute got a little bit brighter. He says, be of good courage. And he said, he will strengthen your heart. That's a guarantee, y'all. He didn't say, I might strengthen your heart. He didn't say, maybe strengthen your heart. But he said, he shall strengthen your heart. But I leave here tonight, you can't just get there. But there are some steps you gotta take. You gotta have a positive attitude. You got to have a positive outlook on God. Because his track record is that he will take care of his own. Have I got a witness? Because it was this same David that said in Psalm 35, he said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. Got a witness. It's the same Lord that Paul said that he shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory. Have I got a witness? It was Jesus that said in this world you gonna have some tribulation. Have I got a witness? But he said, be of good cheer, for I've already overcome the world. You ought to check his track record because he said, if you abide in me and my word abide in you, he said, ask what you will and it shall be given. Have I got a witness? I see some of y'all here tonight. You want to do it. His track record really works. I wish I had Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Have I got a witness? The Lord don't do it, but we know that our God is able, and there ought to be some for you tonight. You don't know when he gonna bring you out, but just knowing that your God is able, that ought to carry you through, and you ought to have memories of how the Lord has brought you through. Have I got a witness? Act like it's the first time that we've ever been through any trouble. Can I get a witness? But if we look back over our lives, this ain't the first time that we've ever been down. This ain't the first time that we've ever had any problems. But if the Lord brought you through the first time, he'll do it again. Have I got a witness? That's why David said, wait on him and be a good cheer. That's why Isaiah could say, wait, they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They'll mount up like wings of eagles. They'll run and not be weary. They'll walk and not faint. If you don't mind tonight, won't you just grab a neighbor by the hand? Have I got a witness? And just shake their hand and say, neighbor, I don't know what you're going through. What you're dealing with, but tell him the God I serve, he's able to bring you out. Tell him the God I serve, he's able to bring you through. And you know, folk get nosy sometimes, they want to know how you know. Tell him I tried.
That's the problem in church today. We don't want to encourage nobody. We don't want to talk to nobody. But tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, tell them hang on in there. Tell them be not dismayed. Tell them whatever be tied. Tell them God will. Tell them God will. God will. You ought to at least lift up your hands. You ought to at least lift up your voice and say, I know he will. Listen, I've been in revival for 5 nights straight. Have I got a witness? Didn't feel real good this evening, but I know my God is good. Have I got a witness? I know that he's able. If you know he's able, won't you just shake that neighbor hand one more time and say, neighbor, tell him I know he's all right. Tell him I know he's all right. Anybody here know he's all right? Anybody know he's all right?
Jesus wants you while you got still have that juice in you.
Yeah.
Because you ought to come